Would you like to learn about Secure Access, Secure Edge, otherwise known as SASE? If so, this video is for you. Hi, my name is Michael Gibbs, and I'm the founder and CEO of GoCloud Careers. And I've been a network architect now for over 25 years. And there's a new technology or framework called Secure Access, Secure Edge, otherwise known as SASE, which I find exciting, and it's critical information for a cloud architect or a network engineer or even a network architect or security professionals in today's world. And what is SASE really? It's a framework that merges the agility of network management with robust security measures at the same time. And it's really designed for the modern cloud-centric business landscape. And SASE isn't just another technical acronym. It's really a transformative approach that enables secure and seamless access to a globally distributed workforce. And what's really going on here is we're integrating network functions with security services. And by doing so, we've got some seamless connectivity with some strong security and the flexibility and agility to adapt to business needs. Now, SASE really came out of some of the need of dealing with a remote workforce and the widespread adoption of cloud services, because we needed something different than the traditional perimeter-based security models, because where is the perimeter in today's world? And this shift underscores why SASE is becoming so important in a world where the boundaries of workspaces are being redefined constantly. So let's talk about how SASE works. First, SASE is really a framework. And it's an integrative approach to provide secure, reliable resources from anywhere without relying on any traditional hardware-based solutions. So let's talk about one of the core components of SASE, software-defined wide area networking. And if you're unfamiliar with software-defined wide area networking, you can see our video on what is SASE. I'll have a link for that in the description of this video. But SD-WAN, as a refresher, is a key technology that's going to enable businesses to manage and optimize their network traffic across multiple transport types, whether they be broadband internet, MPLS-enabled VPNs, cellular networks, or even private lines. And software-defined networking, or SD-WAN, really creates an overlay network that abstracts the underlying physical infrastructure from the overlay network, allowing for intelligent routing based upon traffic, based upon application requirements, or network conditions such as congestion along the primary path. Now, because SD-WAN separates the control plane from the forwarding plane, otherwise known as the data plane, it's got that transport independence. And by doing so, it enables us to connect any network to any network. Another key component of SASE is something called Firewall as a Service. And Firewall as a Service need to provide advanced firewall capabilities such as stateful packet inspection, intrusion detection and prevention, and application layer filtering, delivered as a cloud-based service. And by moving the firewall functionality to the cloud, businesses can benefit from, you know, good scalable protection without the need to deploy and manage physical appliances at potentially 20 or 30 or 40,000 remote workers' locations, let alone the organization's offices, wherever they'd be. Now, another key component of the SASE framework is something called the Cloud Access Security Broker. And the Cloud Access Security Broker is going to help businesses secure their applications and data by enforcing security policies, monitoring user activity, and even detecting potential threats. And it will provide visibility and control over cloud usage, and it'll help ensure that only authorized users can access sensitive resources and that the data is going to be protected from unauthorized access. Another key component of SASE is the Zero Trust Network Access Framework. And this is really a model that operates in the principle of least privilege, granting access to resources based upon a user's identity, device posture, and context. And by doing so, we minimize the attack surface and reduce the risk of, say, lateral movement within the network, because access is going to be granted on a per application basis rather than at a network level. For example, if it's all permitted, it's just all permitted. The true power of SASE is the seamless integration of all the components of SD-WAN, Firewall as a Service, the Cloud Access Security Broker, and the Zero Trust Network Access. So, for example, SD-WAN ensures that we have optimal performance and connectivity. The firewall as a service protects the edge where, or the boundaries or perimeter, wherever that may be. And the cloud access security broker is about securing the traffic and protecting the cloud applications. And then by adding that zero trust network access, we can govern access to resources based upon user identity and context. And by combining all of these, we can have a very good, very secure network. SASE is basically a cloud-native architecture, and by doing so, it enables rapid scalability and flexibility, allowing the businesses to easily adapt to changing network environments or requirements. Now let's talk about the business benefits provided by SASE. And in today's world, businesses are at a crossroads. They need to increase security, but they also need to increase efficiency, and they need some flexibility along the way, because now we don't just have 3 or 4 or 10 offices and, you know, some remote workers. Where people are accessing the systems could literally be anywhere in the world right now. So today's world is dealing with more than just changing hardware. We need a comprehensive solution, and the SASE provides that comprehensive solution. Because we can use software-defined networking, we can have much cheaper wide area networks than if we were going to need private lines to get a similar grade of performance. Because we have integrated security and integrated firewalls, there's a lot less to buy and it can become much more efficient. And because we've accessed zero trust, now we've got extra security and flexibility in a simple to manage solution, which should provide lower cost to our clients and more agility. And agility, or the ability to change, is really something that's incredible for businesses, because if they can adopt a new product or new service quicker than their competitors, it can mean a lot to the organization and its profitability long term. So now you know, what is SASE, how does SASE work, and the business benefits provided by SASE. Now, if your goal is to become a cloud architect or an enterprise architect or an artificial intelligence architect, or honestly an architect of any kind, please join us for one of our completely free webinars. We hold them on Zoom. We can have a full conversation and answer your questions and do anything we can to assist you, and they're completely free. We also have a tremendous number of e-publications to assist you in your career, help you determine how to become an architect, help you win the interview, help you teach you how to earn more in your tech career, and they're all free courtesy of GoCloud Careers. The link is in the description below. If you've enjoyed this video, please give it a like, and please subscribe to the channel and hit the bell to be notified of new videos to help you with your technology career. This is Mike Gibbs signing off for now. I hope to see you in one of our free webinars or another video very soon. Take care.